guys, welcome to another session of Learning with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, I'll be solving questions 26 to question 30 of the Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 4. Have you subscribed to this channel? If you haven't, please do so right now to be able to get more videos like this. Also, don't forget to like and comment on this video. Okay, so the first question in this video says, a car travels at 26 km per hour and completes a journey in 32 hours. How long will it have taken to complete the same journey at a speed of 16 km per hour? So this is actually very, very easy. Okay, so now the first part of this question says, a car travels at 26 km per hour and completes a journey in 32 hours. So we have to calculate the distance of this journey first. Okay, so distance is given as speed times time. The speed is 26 km per hour and then the time taken is 32 hours. Okay, so let's multiply 26 km per hour by 32 hours now. We can do that here. 2 times 6 is 12, write to carry 1. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. 3 times 6 is 18, write 8, carry 1. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7. So let's add this together. 2 plus nothing is 2. 5 plus 8 is 13. Write 3, carry 1. 1 plus 7 is 8. Okay, so the answer is 832 kilometers. So the distance for this first journey is 832 kilometers. So the second part says, how long will it have taken to complete the same journey, that is the same distance, at a speed of 16 kilometers per hour? So we're going to use the same distance as the first journey. Okay, so the distance is 832 kilometers. Then the speed is 16 kilometers per hour. So now we have to find the time. Time is distance over speed. Okay, the distance is 832 kilometers divided by the speed, which is 16 kilometers per hour. Kilometer divides kilometer. So now we have 822 divided by 16 hours. Okay, let's do that here using the long division method. So we find the first possible digit that is divisible by 16. A 3 divided by 16 is 5. 5 times 16 is 80. 83 minus 80 is 3. Then 3 is not divisible by 16, so we have to drop down the next digit, which is 2. So we have 32. 32 divided by 16 is 2. 2 times 16 is 32. Then 32 minus 32 is 0. So we've been able to completely divide 832 by 16. So the answer is 52 hours. So this means that it will take 52 hours to complete the same journey at a speed of 16 km per hour. Okay, so the answer is 52 hours. So the correct option here is option C. Check. Question 27. Evaluate 39 square. Okay, so we are to evaluate 39 square. But first of all, what is the square of a number? The square of a number is the value that is obtained when the number is multiplied by itself. So the square of 2 is 2 times 2, which is 4. The square of 3 is 3 times 3, which is 9. Okay, so this means that 39 squared is 39 multiplied by itself. 39 multiplied by 39. So let's do that here. 9 times 9 is 81. Write 1, carry 8. 9 times 3 is 27. 27 plus 8 is 35. So 351 is the first partial product, that is 39 multiplied by 9. Okay, 3 times 9 is 27, write 7, carry 2. 3 times 3 is 9, 9 plus 2 is 11. So the second partial product is 1170. 39 multiplied by 30. The place value of 3 in 39 is 30. So that is why it's 30. Okay, now let's add the first and second partial product to get the final product. 1 plus 0 is 1. 5 plus 7 is 12, write 2, carry 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. Then 1 plus nothing is 1. So the final product is 1521. So 29 squared is equal to 1521. So you can see that finding the square of a number is very easy. Just multiply the number by itself. Okay, so 39 squared is 1521. So the correct option here is option D. Check. Question 28. 32 laborers can finish a piece of work in 294 days. How many days will it take 98 laborers to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? Okay, so this is very easy. Now, when the number of laborers increase, the time taken to complete the work will decrease. Now, let me create a scenario. For example, you're given a plate of food to share among three people. It could take you maybe about 10 minutes to finish the food. But imagine if there are 10 people that want to share that same plate of food. It will take you less time to complete the food, right? Okay, so this means that when the number of laborers increase, the time taken to complete the job will decrease. So this means that the number of laborers is inversely proportional to the number of days. Okay, so what does inverse proportion mean? Inverse proportion occurs when one value decreases and the other increases, or when one value increases and the other decreases. Okay, so since they work at the same rate, we are going to be using the formula T equals K over N, where T is the time, that is the number of days, K is the constant of proportionality or rate of change, and N is the number of laborers. Okay, so now we've been given the time. The time that it will take them to finish the piece of work is 294 days. Then the number of laborers is 32. So now let's find the constant of proportionality. So let's make K the subject of the formula. So we cross multiply. K equals 294 multiplied by 32. We can do that here. 2 times 4 is 8. 2 times 9 is 18. Write 8, carry 1. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. 3 times 4 is 12. Write 2, carry 1. 3 times 9 is 27. 27 plus 1 is 28. Write 8, carry 2. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. So now let's add this together. 8 plus nothing is 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. Write 0, carry 1. 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 plus 8 is 14. So write 4, carry 1. 1 plus 8 is 9. Okay? So this means that 294 multiplied by 32 is 9,408. So the constant of proportionality, or the rate of change, is 9,408. So the rate they are working is 9,408. Okay? So now what do we do? We have to answer the question. The question says, how many days will it take 98 laborers to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? So we've been able to find the rate. The rate is 9,408. So how many days will it take 98 laborers to finish this same work? Okay, so now that we have the K to be 9,408, and then the number of laborers is now 98 laborers. So we can still use this formula, T equals K over N. So we have T equals 9,408 divided by 98. Let's do that here using the long division method. So we have to find the first possible digit that is divisible by 98. 940 divided by 98 is 9. 9 times 98 is 882. 0 minus 2 is not possible. So we get 1 from 4. It remains 3. Put the 1 here. It becomes 10. 10 minus 2 is 8. 3 minus 8 is not possible, so we get 1 from 9, it remains 8. We put the 1 here, it becomes 13. 13 minus 8 is 5, so we have 58. 58 is not divisible by 98, so we drop down the next digit, which is 8. So we have 588. 588 divided by 98 is 6. 6 times 98 is 588. 588 minus 588 is 0. So we've been able to completely divide 9,408 by 98. So the answer is 96. So this means that it will take 96 days for 98 laborers to complete the work. So you can see now that the higher the number of laborers, the less time they require to finish the piece of work, because 32 laborers are going to finish the work in 294 days. That's a long time. But when the numbers of laborers have been increased to 98 laborers, it will reduce the time. So the time that will take 98 laborers to finish this work is 96 days. Okay? So the answer is 96 days. So the correct option here is B, 96 days. Check. Question 29. Express MM, CC, XXX as an Arabic numeral. Do you know what Arabic numerals are? So Arabic numerals are the 10 digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Those are the Arabic numerals. So these are the Roman numerals converted to Arabic numerals. So M is 1000, D is 500, C is 100, L is 50, X is 10, V is 5, I is 1. So it's very important that you know this to be able to convert Roman numerals to Arabic numerals or Arabic numerals to Roman numerals. Okay, so MMCCXXX is M plus M plus C plus C plus X plus X plus X. M is 1000, M is 1000, C is 100, C is 100, X is 10, X is 10, X is 10. So we have 1000 plus 1000 plus 100 plus 100 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. 1000 plus 1000 is 2000. 100 plus 100 is 200. 10 plus 10 plus 10 is 30. So 2000 plus 200 is 2200. 2200 plus 30 is 2230. So this means that MMCCXXX is 2230 in Arabic numerals. So it's very easy. Just know the Roman numerals to Arabic numerals, and you'll be able to convert any Roman numeral to Arabic numeral or any Arabic numeral to Roman numerals. Okay, so the answer here is 2230. So the correct option is option A, 2230. Check. Question 30. What is the HCF of 14 and 28? Okay, so HCF means highest common factor. So we are going to use the prime factorization method to find the HCF of these numbers. So the first thing is to express each of the numbers as a product of its prime factors. So what are prime factors? Prime factors are the prime numbers that you multiply together to get a number. Okay, so the prime factors of 14 are 2 and 7. 2 multiplied by 7 will give 14. Then the prime factors of 28 are 2 times 2 times 7, which will give 28, right? So now we find the common factors of 14 and 28. 2 is a common factor of 14 and 28. Then 7 is also a common factor of 14 and 28. So the common factors of 14 and 28 is 2 and 7. Okay? Then HCF, that is highest common factor, is the product of the common factors. So you multiply the common factors to get the HCF. So 2 and 7 are the common factors. So 2 multiplied by 7 is 14. As simple as that. So express each of the numbers as the product of its prime factors. Find the common factors, then multiply them to get the HCF. As simple as A, B, C. Okay, so the correct option here is option A, 14. Because the HCF of 14 and 28 is 14. Check! I hope you enjoyed this video and you're able to learn a lot. Please don't forget to like and comment on this video. Also, subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this that will help you in preparation for your exam. Till I come your way next time. Bye!